Tiger Walk, first Tiger Walk of the season. With all the fans, man, it's nothing but a blessing. AB in the back. Yeah. It's lit!
A lot of people got to come out. We really enjoyed it. Got to see all the fans today.
Just dominated. Ready for the next game, next opponent.
We already know it was live out here. You know, Furman did their thing. We did our thing. But yeah, it was great. Great experience. All the fans came out. Shout out to the fans.
Glad to be out there with an amazing fan base. Got my first forward recovery.
Hey, it's fun.
Hey, we love the fans, baby. We love them.
You know, fans came out, showed love. I'm loving it, man. It's great.
Had a great time out here, man. Got my first touchdown. It's so great to be in Death Valley.
Glad to be here, man. Great to be back in the Valley. You know, we reached our goal, man. 1-0. That's the goal every time.
Enjoyed it. Thank you. Death Valley, you're awesome.
We settled in. Once we got settled down, we were able to establish a line of scrimmage, run the football.
Right, like on the bus ride, I had some chills. I was getting goosebumps and stuff. But once I got out there, started moving everything kind of went away.
But I thought everybody was a little bit antsy. They were all anxious to play. But once they settled down, they looked like what we thought they were.
No, I was talking to X on the bus. We couldn't really, like, prepare, you know, for something like that. Finally just get to go out there and have fun. You know, it was something I wasn't even ready to imagine.
All right, just finished interviews, just finished the game. Oh, man, what an experience. All the fans, thank you for coming out and supporting us. You know, it was really special to look up in the crowd, you know, hear your cheers. And so now, you know, we're going to enjoy this win. But tomorrow, back at it, you know, just getting ready for practice, getting prepared for the week, and just getting ready to head out to Texas.
We'll be right back.
It's a wrap. Hey, I'm heading out in the morning. Got the Texas A&M game plan going out Thursday. Team's going out Friday. We got the trip plan for 300 people, 2 planes, 7 buses, 2 hotels. I'm heading out Thursday morning early to make sure that all the details are in order, the movie theater, the airport, all those things that we've been working on since January. And later on this season, you're gonna get a chance to see everything that we do and how we pull an operation like this off. But in the meantime,
I can see the quarterback rolling and running free.
I just remember being one-on-one.
Best thing for me to do was to stay square. When he got as close as possible, I felt like I wanted to pick him up and drive him into the ground.
Trying to escape the orange pressure, and he gets upended. Avon, textbook tackle to put the quarterback on the ground.
My mentality in the game is just be aggressive and physical as possible. Don't let anybody block you.
Don't let anybody run you over.
Don't let nobody just think they could just run to your side. Nothing like that. And that's what happened on that play. Just coming in, making that big hit, telling him no.
Some veteran, you know, Keith advice leading up to this first away game. First and foremost, make sure you have all your issues, you know, gear, all your stuff.
We need to go on a silent count because this stadium's gonna be insane. It's gonna be stupid loud.
Keep that confidence. We believe in all you guys.
Stay poised, do what you gotta do, go through your progressions. You were born to do this, you were born to play football. Be great at that.
Appreciate the advice. Definitely gonna be a big week in practice, getting ready for that atmosphere.
Just gotta stay calm and do our job like Kayvon said.
This team is definitely prepared. After game one, I seen that.
You could tell that we had practiced. You know, we put the work in over the offseason and the summer, as well as in camp.
How focused we were, how relentless we can be when we're all on the same page.
We're like brothers.
This team can do whatever we put our mind to.
And we're deep throughout the whole team. Third string, second string, first string.
You just gotta keep staying focused.
So this team is gonna play to a standard every week. It doesn't really matter who we're playing or where we're playing.
All right, that's it for the media. Now it's time to go get cooking. Your boy is hungry.
That did a little swiping. You like a little
swiping. Wow.
If you don't already know us, I'm Donna. And I'm Hallie. And you're watching All in the Kitchen.
All right, so I just got my chicken. I'm about to throw it on here, get it ready to cook. I'm flipping the chicken right now.
Put my veggies in now.
Why do we like it now?
Because it's healthy.
What is it?
Keep you hot, man.
We're learning.
I am.
Why do we like salt in the food?
So it keeps you hydrated.
That's,
you know,
right.
Salt absorbs the water.
Yeah, what he said.
That's right.
All right, I'm mixing it all in because, you know, you can't just have the veggies on top and the meat at the bottom or the veggies won't cook. So you just got to mix it in so it all can cook. Like,
he came in with some skills. He said that he could cook. So we're seeing what he can do.
Might turn out really good.
Right.
It's looking like an A right now.
You think that looks done to you?
What does done chicken look like? Pink or white?
White.
Yeah, a little white.
Let's break open a big piece right there. Oh, it's good. It's good to me.
Yeah.
It's juicy.
Yeah.
All right.
Juicy.
No more protein and veggies on top.
Gotta throw some garnish on top, but you know, gotta make it look good.
I gotta get my yum yum sauce.
There you go.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
I'm top it up with the yum yum sauce. Gotta zoom in on that. Ooh. We're ready to go. All right, now it's time to eat it.
You didn't even say yum. I did good.
Good to see how you.
Yep. In the kitchen, wrist twisted like a stir fry. Put it in the kitchen, wrist twisted like a stir fry.
Equipment truck is packed. It's on its way to College Station. Got College game day this weekend. Got to have our guys looking good. So I'm going to show you guys some of our travel gear and some of the new stuff we got this season. Going to start off with our travel bag. Every player gets one of these. Really nice switch up from what we've been having. It's really nice. But there's goodies inside this bag as well. Start off with travel top. Really nice. The guys will be wearing this Friday night at the movies. Next up, we got the pants to the top. Matching top, matching bottom. Got to have everybody looking the same. Then we've got the two shirts. This is the orange shirt. It's the gray version right there. It's basically the same thing. Really comfortable travel shoes. Free trainers. They actually have tiger stripes down in the insoles, and they got the tiger paw right here. Looks really nice. Last but not least, we got recovery tights. So our guys will wear these after the game, basically just to help recover you after a game, make you feel good. And in addition to our travel gear, we've also got new equipment for on the field, like gloves and cleats. So let's start off with the gloves. Right here, we got the new Vapor Jet. Most receivers, corners, tight ends, skill guys will wear this glove right here. It's all white. It's got the, you got the tiger paw right here on the inside. Probably our most popular glove this year. Same thing right here. Comes in orange and purple. Really good look. Like it a lot. Next up, we've got the super bad. So this has got some padding to it. As you can see, tight ends, linebackers, anybody that's, you know, kind of more physical will wear these just because they've got more padding on the back end. Right here is the Vapor Knit. Really good look. Tiger paw also. Everything's got the tiger paw in them. That glove also comes in white. The Vapor Knit. This is another really popular glove. A lot of receivers wear it. A lot of corners wear it. Looks really good. Now we'll go on to the cleats. We got our new deal with Nike, as you guys have seen. They really take care of us with our new SMU cleats, special makeup. So we've got chrome bottoms, as you can see right here. Untouchable Speed 3. This is a low top cleat. A lot of guys like it. It's really lightweight. It's got the chrome bottoms on here, as you can see here. It's also got a tiger paw on the tongue. Really nice, got Clemson on the back. Next up, this is the best cleat from this year, in my opinion. A lot of quarterbacks wear it. Trevor wears it. Kelly wears it. A lot of guys wear this. The Untouchable Pro 3. Same thing. Tiger paw here. It's a really good looking shoe. Alpha Menace Elite. Aw, oh, dang it. That's not the Alpha Menace Elite. Let me redo that. The Untouchable 3 Elite. And these cleats are really nice, like I said. With, you know, Nike really took care of us with the chrome bottoms on here. They look really good. This is a high top cleat. A lot of tight ends like this one, linebackers. So it's really good looking. Alpha Menace. This is a sleeper pick right here. This one's really nice. Tavian Feaster wore these last week. Mainly defensive ends, linebackers, but a couple of skill players do like it. Next up, do I need to bring the box out?
Oh, I've shown the box.
It's shown the box. It is. As you can tell from this box, this is a Bigfoot. So. Take a look at what's inside the box. We got the big boys some swag this year. We got the Savage Elite. It's a high top cleat. You know, they always complain they don't get any love. So here's their love right here. Chrome bottoms, SMU cleat from Nike. Looks really good. Tiger paw on the tongue. It's got little ridges on the front just for protection on your toe box. Give you a lot of ankle support too. So there's that option. Last but not least, is another lineman shoe. It's a little bit lower cut. If you guys want a little more, you know, movement, range of motion in their ankle. Everything this year from Nike is just awesome. They really took care of us this year. Our guys really appreciate it. We appreciate it because, you know, you look good, you play good. So looking forward to a great weekend in Texas A&M.
My shoulder's getting tired, so I'm gonna have to wrap this up. And the other thing,
you're really getting paid a lot to shoot. I've got a new job for you on game day.
The other thing I would say is another word besides culture is consistency.
Yeah.
It's been incredible
to
watch.
Hold that for you?
I'm gonna do fourth quarter mat jumps to get through this.
Okay.
No, really, the consistency. Like I said, guys like Deshaun leave. Here comes another wave of great players, and they send players to the NFL. And yet the continuity on the staff and the consistency of the brand, I mean, they've become a perennial top five program. That's just who they are. And it's cool to be able to watch them here early in the year and see how they do on the road against Texas A&M.